Hello and welcome to This and That. I am Dave Lees.
Oh, I see what you did. And I am Jonathan Beyer.
This is the skating lesson where we are going to discuss everything going on in the skating world. So please smash that like button and hit subscribe below. Jonathan, it finally is exciting skating season. I feel refreshed.
Yeah.
Ted's enthusiasm was coming through the screen.
It was a sense of normalcy. I was like, right, Ted, live streaming YouTube. All right, this is feeling like old times.
Oh my God. Well, it started with Sam Chouinard hosting the I Am Live event. Now imagine.
And they were, yeah.
I had to be on a WebEx while this was going on. So I totally had one computer. Thankfully we're muted on one, like one eye in case anything interesting is happening at any moment.
Yeah, exactly. Grab the screen grabs as you can get them, yeah.
So, okay, let's just start with the AM Live event. We'll go in chronological order from this very exciting weekend.
I was born October 11th. Oh, this week, sorry, okay.
So, Friday, we get to I Am Live, and it starts with Olivia and Adria. And, pretty much the I Am Live thing has been very vague. And we couldn't tell how many people were on. It was a new streaming service that they're producing live. And I do have a lot of respect because I've been kind of wondering, what is Marie France's and her team's, Romain's husband, like, they have their skating school that they branded. They now have their own agency that many skaters are becoming a part of. But what is the master plan? And especially this year, we can't have any shows, right?
Right.
But they have a paid event to watch the first skating we've seen in a year. And then they bring in the On Ice Perspectives guy. Again, to me, these are all very smart moves that
100%. And a great way to watch ice dancing. More than any other discipline, I think it's so effective for.
And yeah, you can't have a show per se, but how genius is this that in a time when we all can't be together in an arena to watch skating together, and she knows how international skating is, even if ice dance is perhaps the most obscure of the disciplines, they're going to get, and they have teams from everywhere, they're going to have viewers from around the world. And that's why it was at 1 p.m. so that they could get different people from different countries. I thought it was what we would expect from Marie France. Oh, thinking ahead, right? I also think IMG is going to hate her in 0.2 seconds now that they realize what she is up to. Right. I think maybe they won't let certain teams in certain shows, but really IMG doesn't really have a leg to stand on outside of Japanese shows and maybe some endorsements. They really, their Stars on Ice tour in North America is failing, that they had to join Canada and the US together. And I'm amused because I think skating clearly needs something forward thinking and some new blood that they've kind of just been letting this model wilt and die for the last 20 years. So I thought that I think they need someone to come
in. It was finally a new model. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
It's something completely different and someone within the system, because if you try to do something in skating as kind of an outsider, the powers that be will push you and stamp you down all along, but they can't do this to Marie France because she's Marie France. So it all kind
of... And it's this time. She's the one answering the call of what's needed in this time. Like, I just reread Scott Hamilton's book because we were talking about it. And like, Stars on Ice was such a novel concept in the early 90s. Like,
yeah.
Why would it still be the model we're like just clinging on to in 2020?
Yeah. So I think it's smart. And look, if they can start getting endorsements for skaters, oh my... Could they like nab someone like Nathan Chen or the next Nathan Chen in a country,
right.
They could, the next up and coming skater, as soon as they start landing some endorsement deals for people, I would be very curious to see how quickly that monopoly falls, because it's been needing to. And I think when you see this generation of agents like a Yuki Sagusa retire, maybe it can bring new opportunities to skating in the internet era. So anyway, I thought it was interesting. I thought it was smart. In terms of the actual skating, some of the teams, so these teams were not all skating during quarantine, right? The Montreal, Canada took it very seriously, and the ones that were in Montreal were not skating. But some of the teams showed us new material, some of the teams showed us old material. They were very smart and they didn't have people actually do the pattern sections where they could mess up and perhaps judges could zero in on some edges and pay attention when they're not ready.
Yeah.
It gave them a rest to really show things full out. I thought with Olivia and Adria, they showed us their Grease program, which they retooled a bit. I thought that their unison looked better in the first section. They went in, and as the program went along, they started to skate like themselves, where they're this talented team, but then they always seem to hot mess themselves out of a winning, triumphant moment. So they did this thing where they showed this lift, and they botched it in the run-through, and they went to do it after the program to prove that they could do it. And being live, they missed it again and it was worse. But you know, that's what live things are all about. So that's—
it's like a real practice session, yeah.
Yeah, so that was kind of interesting. The only, we saw in the practice, which we didn't see, is the British team, Fear and Gibson, is gonna, I think, doing the Lion King, it looked like. We didn't see that in the actual performance. Chalk and Bates were out due to an injury that they were very vague about, but they have a new free dance. But they were talking that they want to keep the snake program or do it as a exhibition or bring it back. It's who, I mean, I don't know if that's going to be like their Olympic, I think they could do something even better. So
I think so. I think they've got like the right idea going. It doesn't have to be that one, but that kind of ideology will get them so far.
We did see Hubbell and Donohue, and I was relieved that I personally liked their rhythm dance better than last year, because you know that if you don't like a Hubbell and Donohue program, their parents tend to be very vocal in the internet and people will, right. I like it better than last year. I like it better than the year before in terms of their free dance from the year before. I don't know without seeing the finished product how good it is, but they're skating to burlesque. So it's Christina Aguilera's big in your face energy. They're both in your face people. I'm gonna think it's better. You're gonna hate it because you're gonna hate Christina Aguilera and burlesque.
No, I love Christina Aguilera. I think she's a very talented singer. I saw her in burlesque. The movie, I almost called it a film. I think that's an overreach.
This was not her.
No, I thought she was fine. It's, I'm sure.
I mean, these are not her
glory days. What I remember is they didn't give her good material. It's just like happens in skating. Good voice, not the right material.
So it kind of works for their rhythm dance, definitely better than last year's rhythm dance with the Marilyn Monroe thing.
Just by the descriptors you gave it, like in your face, it's big, it's like a moment, versus the other thing was like cutesy and coy and flirty.
I think the second piece they use is better towards the end. It's hard because they took out a middle section and then we see it at the end, but I thought it looked much better. He looks in much better shape than he did last year. Overall, they looked ready. It's going to be interesting to see how they compete against Chalk and Bates. Obviously, they are skating longer. Chalk and Bates are off. How about Donohue have more power if they can keep pushing? I do think it's going to be hard when you have Chalk and Bates have like this new creative energy. She's clearly the muse for that costume designer. This is ice dance, things like costumes and music.
Who wouldn't want a design for her? Yeah.
Like that all... Unfortunately, it matters, right? Like it all, you can bamboozle someone.
Right.
So yeah, it's going to be an interesting matchup. I think that they look pretty good. But you did see Papadakis and Cizeron. I did send that to you.
Yes, yes.
So I was thinking like, I don't know if this is going to be archived. So I was like taking a clip with my phone for you as we were.
Which I appreciated, yes.
Okay, so this was interesting. They only showed us pieces. And remember, they had coronavirus over the summer. So they
Which, again, affecting the upper respiratory stuff, yeah. You know, that's got to be very difficult for stamina.
But we did see them and they had this like whole interesting thing after they did their thing. they're very awkward interviewees. I know you didn't see it at all. I'm like, they're, like, I can't tell what is them being kind of aloof and French and like what is them being like a little
bit. Well, I could see them protective. So when we did our interview with them, it just took a while. You just had to make them feel safe.
But there's still,
and then they get chatting.
So they were saying that, like, she was like, oh, I forgot that we were skating today for the public. And you're like, as if Marie France didn't make that very clear that you were
right.
doing
a that they weren't setting the connections all week or whatever.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you know what?
Fine.
It reminded me of high school. Because they remind me of the valedictorians of the class, right? I think people do that when they're so much better to appear relatable, but they just don't know that it seems silly.
Right.
So we went in alphabetical order. In high school, we sat alphabetical order almost every class. I always sat next to Karina Lamb. We wound up becoming very, you know, good friends. She was the valedictorian, and we would have tests, and she'd be like, oh, I so failed. And, you know, there are some tests that, like, yeah, I could bomb. And meanwhile, Karina never bombed. She went to Harvard Medical School, full scholarship. Okay.
Okay, like, yeah, she didn't bomb.
She did not bomb. Okay.
Okay.
It also didn't make me feel more relatable to her because I actually was like, no, like, you might have gotten a 96 and maybe I legitimately bombed. So that's kind of reminded me of. But I thought they're doing a tango. It's like is it La Compresita that they're doing like an arrangement of? I wasn't sure exactly.
Yeah, I enjoyed the music. I mean, when I first, did we know they were doing a tango or was it literally upon this viewing that we are like,
they were
doing a tango? And then what was your first knee-jerk reaction?
Oh my God, I don't know if you can hear me say it in the clip I sent you, but just from the original when like he goes around her back and then he goes around the front, like, and there, I was like, I love this.
I do too.
Moment one. It's sophisticated, it's unique, it's not their usual anything in their wheelhouse. You know,
but you know what I like about it, Dave, is it's not their usual, but this is still definitely their version in a positive way of a tango. Because I associate the tango as all of these sharp, jerky movements, right? And they do have sharp movements, but it's still very much with their soft-kneed, fluid approach.
A loungy, sexy tango. And the...
It's a unique tango. Like, I thought Piper and Paul's tango was interesting because it was obviously very specific and, you know, creative in certain hand gestures and holds and things like that. But this was taking, like, a sharp, angular tango and putting it in their style.
Oh,
and I loved
it. Tango is like... having like relations with like an ex-lover like in a smoke-filled room in Argentina. Like this is...
Yeah, but it's not just like angry passion or fiery passion. It's also like kind of beautiful, elegant passion at the same time. Yeah.
So I thought there were some moments where you could tell where like his movement is defined and it just looked like she was kind of standing there. Like maybe they haven't finished all the fill-ins of the choreography yet. They said it was a work in progress, so.
And some of the on-ice perspectives, I mean, again, it's no news that he's the most lovely skater ever, but to get some of his angles to really see that lean, you know, as they're making a curve or something like that, it was just sensational. And again, same thing that happens in singles right now. So much is still formulaic. At this juncture. And people were arguing that their style had become formulaic, but ice dance can be so formulaic. So it was just so nice to see new everything. Nothing was
time. And Katsalapov are also getting formulaic with that one style that they have with their free dance. So I was ready for them to do something different and agreeing to disagree about the spoken word poem that I think was more of a miss last season.
Yeah.
This one is way more positive. And I'm curious to see their material going forward. I think they said they were gonna do a new rhythm dance. It sounded like, but yeah, they were being protective and keeping us guessing. So I was here for it, so.
Which they did with the fame, which was great too.
Yeah, it was good. Overall, I think it was a successful event. I definitely think it was worth paying for. And would
do it again.
Yeah, I hope Scott, I found the Sam Chouinard guy, though energetic, was like so stereotypical, almost reminded me of like Rusty.
Oh, yeah.
Like so I would hope that they would like have Scott Moyer host without Tessa so that you get kind of Scott's humor and less of like the veneer. right?
Yeah, lighthearted, but also classy. You know what I mean? Because that's their MO up there. They're above kind of rusty-esque sort of entertainment.
Yeah. And Scott Moyer is working with Hubbell and Donohue. He choreographed their free dance. We saw like a few seconds without music. So anyway, it looks promising. It looks like they have some good energy behind them. Yeah, all the teams looked pretty together. So I think it'll be a curious thing. But we also, before we get into Russia, we had a few clips of Japan. And I know you love Japanese skaters. So it was supposed to be the Dreams on Ice show, which is usually, I think, in July. And it was...
And some triple axels from our Japanese friends.
We did. And they really ran it kind of like a competition. It had a competition warm-up. They did their competition programs. And we saw some good triple axels. I mean, we saw Mana, the Mia Hamada student, did a triple axel. We saw Wakaba do a triple axel in the warm-up. That was really, really nice.
And she gets it. And it was like back in the day when, and we'll get to Kolyada in a whole dissertation I have coming, but like when that quad lutz happened, it was the best. That's how I feel about Wakaba. She's not always getting it, but man, when she gets it, do I love it.
Yeah, I thought that both Japanese girls that we saw that were the strong contenders, meaning Kaori and Wakaba, lumping them together here, I think that they both look pretty strong, pretty prepared, and knowing how they usually get together throughout a season, I think they've got a shot. And knowing what we've seen from Rika.
Knowing how rough things were at this point last season for them, and knowing that they ended up finding their way.
The way coronavirus just hit, to have people be off kilter, should there be a Worlds this year in the spring, not knowing what's gonna happen in the coming months with, you know, the models that we see, and I think that people are pretty committed to trying to make something work for a competition, whether, right? I think the Japanese girls are really in it. So what we've seen, I don't, like last year, they really weren't, right? They were really-
Almost they decided as a group to collectively be a little rough in the start, yeah.
This year, seeing the mess in Moscow, I think that they have as good of a chance of anyone to be competitive this season. Quads, no quads. Like they, I liked.
Triple axels, especially if they're throwing them in the shorts. You know what I mean? They can really make some.
They look soft, they look strong. They looked ready. Yeah. So. And I thought our team Coco looked very good for, right, getting out there for dance. They also, we saw a clip of them in the Montreal event. So I thought that they looked pretty good. I didn't see videos of the Japanese men. They did skate there, but I didn't see them uploaded. So I don't really have any thoughts about them.
I think as we might have signed on, they started coming out.
Uploaded, yeah. So we didn't see them by the time that we did this, but I actually haven't read reports on how they did, but I want to see those videos and maybe we'll discuss them next week. So
Exactly.
We'll keep guessing, right?
Yeah, like, we'll make you find them in the meantime, yeah.
Yeah, so, all right.
Meanwhile.
Venetian documentary.
Yes, which again, I wish had captioned.
I know. I watched it. Okay, so we filmed the show that I'm working on Wednesday. And this, we had like 4 days and we had to change a bunch of segments and people and things. So like this week was hell week. And I just fell asleep after dinner on Friday night for 5 hours. But I did wake up and like watch the Venetian documentary without any closed captioning and like just like watching them.
Mm-hmm. Well, it was kind of well done, I felt, the film. So like, especially the beginning group exercises and stuff, I felt like it was, from a production standpoint, done nicely.
Yeah, they kind of used like some slow motion and music. I was interested in actually the way that he was managing the group lessons and the way that they were all working on similar exercises with edges and entrances into jumps. And I thought it was actually really interesting to see the way that a group like that functions, because it doesn't happen in the US, it's completely opposite. And there are obviously pluses and minuses to that sort of thing. I thought it was interesting that Samadurova looked really rough, Tutmishva looked rough at that point when it was filmed, but Kolyada, like,
What is, I mean.
He got sinus surgery? It seems like he got a lobotomy, Jonathan. Like, what happened?
I know. The whole look, the demeanor, like he came back. It's like a different person. Like, it's incredible.
Yeah.
And to see Misha, you know.
Misha loves him.
Misha has a type of resting face, perhaps, that makes it look like he is in a perma frown. But to see him like jovially joking with him, I wonder if it hasn't rejuvenated Misha as well. That he's like got his guy. He's got his guy.
My God, and I will just tell you, you went with Aliyev, I went with Kolyada.
Whoa. When do I have to choose between those two? I have always
Jonathan, we have like probably hours of you being like, Aliyev. And
I do love Aliyev, but I love Kolyada also. I think
Aliyev's in Germany with that doctor who's
good. Good, figure out what you need to figure out. But Kolyada, especially when we went back to 2018, and unfortunately, obviously, was not a great event for him, but just the sheer skating skills alone. But we're going to get into that in the men.
Oh my God, with that deep V going on. Oh.
And it was like slightly to the side intentionally, you know, to be that an array of kind of like shoulder action.
Like when you shop at American Apparel and they're like, do you want the V? When the V is already like a little deep, or the deep V. And it was like, well.
It was V and off to the side. That's what made it so like special. So let's just go into it for a second then, because we're here. So when I, having again just revisited 2018 with you, I was just reminded of these like glorious skating skills and all of his tremendous abilities, even when it's not going well. And he came out for this short program here, and I was like, damn it, this is terrible. Like, I hated the posing, I hated the program, I hated the music, but love his skating. I was like, oh no, he's made a huge mistake in going to Misha. But yet the quad seemed so steady, the jumps seemed great, his demeanor seemed really good, his energy was settled. Then turn around to the Soraya program that I think probably could be more sophisticated in a lot of its movement, but yes, just his sheer posture is so freaking good.
Costume and valid. Worked with him, his
life. It was a moment. Give him all the points, all of them. It's gorgeous.
He's my favorite man right now if he does that program.
Same. I think they could. I think just his deportment is what makes it so special. I think like someone could fill in some more sophisticated choreographic moments for him, but oh my gosh, is that sensational. In such stark contrast to what I thought was kind of a cheesy, like typically Mishan short program.
I didn't think it was foamy. It was, it had a more of a big band element to it.
With like the putting out of the cigarette and stuff, I was like, don't make him do that. He's Nureyev. He is this balletic genius. Give him more of that. Like, it was such a success to me.
Speaking of Russian male ballet dancers, do yourself a favor.
Okay.
Get on Amazon Prime or get on our Patreon for See Alive.
Okay.
Because we watched the documentary about Alena Ilyinik's baby daddy, Sergei Polunin. I think it's her fiance now.
There's some ink work that's happening.
If you want to see like a dramatic Russian man, this is your prototype. Okay.
Okay.
I mean, retiring every 18 months. Oh my God. The drama of this, the crazy mother, oh my God. It's incredible. I think they're so right for each other. I mean.
Okay.
I'm going to actually do a second video. Maybe it'll come out tomorrow morning about all of the Russian drama going on to give people not everyone watches the videos over the summer. And then they ask us really annoying questions throughout the season in the comments, and like they'll get very aggressive. And it's like, well, where were you for the last 5 months? But they're just tuning in. I'm going to make a video explaining.
Bring everybody up to speed.
The journey that we've been on, right?
Exactly. Buckle up, buckaroos.
Buckle up. So is Artur Danilian like also at the German doctor? We didn't get the memo on him. I wasn't sure.
Yeah, I expected to see him here and then of course did not.
Zamorin wasn't so good here. Peter Grumenik looked okay.
Yeah, the moment was this Kolyada reveal.
It was all about Kolyada.
In the free. I had to wait for it.
Even in the short, to see him skate so well and with confidence and to see the technique.
That jumping, yeah, for
Jonathan,
sure.
He couldn't get through three elements without popping before. Come on. He was brilliant here.
His time away was well spent, whatever he did.
I was so excited. It was like, his program was very 1999, whatever, that short program. I'm forgetting what it was. like, he came in and went so fast.
Yeah. But
it was, it's on the tip of my tongue. It's like my big bad voodoo daddy, right? Whatever he skated. But anyway, oh my God, it was like, we played it in like jazz band or something. Anyway.
Okay.
Yes. Okay.
With like a lime green cummerbund or something.
Yeah. With another piece. But yeah, no. Anyway.
This Nureyev is a moment. And I would imagine the quads will keep coming. I think they're really gonna.
Well, they're not coming for him though. So they need to come for someone.
Correct.
Yeah. So I think Mishin is in it to win. How interesting that Moskvina and Mishin.
I love their friendship.
But can they wear a mask? I mean, goddamn.
Olga
Morozov is the only person in Russia taking the coronavirus seriously and wearing a mask. The irony. Moskvina, Mishin, Tarasova, these are high-risk individuals, and these are treasures who we need.
Yeah.
Even
in the stands, it was as if we were living in a parallel universe where corona was not real.
There were some in the free who wore masks, but it was few and far between.
I know, but not far apart, because they were all sitting next to each other in the stands.
What's amazing is that they only sold a percentage of the tickets, and they sold out in 10 minutes. So I think they sold maybe, if there was like 10,000, maybe they sold 3,500 or something like that.
But
right?
The point of limited capacity was that, so you're not supposed to be all crammed in, which is what they were. Yeah.
It is Russia. They are all on the Trump train, Jonathan. You just have to, and they know capitalism better than anyone. Okay.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
But the fact that Kolya Morozov is the only one wearing a mask, like the freaking irony of the whole situation was just. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Loved it. Okay. Loved it.
Okay, bring me in on the ladies. I need to dissect this emotionally with you. I have no idea what you think.
Oh, wait. We gotta get it.
Okay.
In the pairs.
Oh, yes.
You know, I've been like critical of Boykova and Kozlovsky stylistically, but they're growing in their technique so much, and even in their Moskvina polishing, but there were moments in that short program where I was like, this is an Olympic champion team. Like, there's actually no way that the Chinese can compete with this. When they do full extension with power, I was like, oh, she's gonna do it again. She's gonna do it again.
It's that reliability. And you just settle in because you know you can feel safe.
And their technique is, it just seems so advanced compared.
Well, he went up for one of the side-by-sides in the free and was like completely parallel with the ice and just completely righted it and landed two more jumps after it. I mean, it's remarkable what they're able to do. Again, I don't find that they're necessarily special, but what makes them so special is this confidence in the skating because you know they're going to hit.
Yeah, and they're developing and it's getting better and better and better. My goodness, they looked so incredible.
Same long.
It's after the side-by-side jumps in the short that I really could see a more sophisticated and confident skating approach. And their jump, it wasn't even perfect. Anyway. And did you watch our girl in the ice dance? We're just going to get into the ladies, okay?
Okay.
Annabelle Morozova. Okay. I will give you that Tiffany Zahorsky and Jonathan may have more unison and a natural glide, right? And I know that his mother is a caller who does the political dirty work for Russia, and she has some of like the British pull. I'm sorry, Annabelle is a freaking star. They should get rid of her partner, steal Jonathan, plug him in. And I think I would have to look at their heights, but okay, and she needs a different dress. I sent her a message. I'm like, this is ice dance. This is not Catholic school. You're dancing to
Well, it's interesting how they all kind of like just decide on this kind of black.
And is your father conservative? Like, what's going on with this costume? Like, no. But she's getting a new one. She wanted us to know.
Okay.
The hair and the makeup was on point. Her expression when she's doing the arm throughout. And honestly, if you saw her skating skills when she started ice dance to where they have come in 4 years, she's stronger than he is. I don't see any reason why they couldn't get to the top in another so many years, right? Like,
you mean if she went with Jonathan or in the current partnership?
I just mean if she keeps pushing and working this hard from where she came from to where she is now, it's unbelievable. And she
because again, I will say in skating in general, we often pretend that we see changes that are not happening.
Jonathan skated like Alena Rudinova, okay? Like,
and and in this instance, you do see like someone grow up. Yeah.
Oh my God. When she's like doing the leg kicks to the side. And, oh dear God. Yes. Okay.
Giving you the business.
Listen, her godmother is Tatiana Tarasova. Like, I just think we...
Sky's the limit.
Sky's the limit. Why not?
Because yeah. I'll tell you, Tiffany and Jonathan...
Where does she get off thinking that she could do Destiny's Child and keep our interest for 4 minutes? Like,
you know, there was that one like kind of empowered lift moment where she lifted her arm and stuff. But it was just kind of a disconnect for me overall with the material.
Like, when her hair is the most interesting thing about the program, we need better packaging.
Well, or at least the dominating thing. It really is.
And I think that that's their coach's issue, is just the material is not...
And as your coach would remind us, not natural. So it doesn't even necessarily come with the fire that comes from a natural.
Is it natural? I don't know, Tiffany's hair. That doesn't look like a color I've seen in nature, but I don't
correct.
Know.
Okay. Correct. Yes, yeah, I was like, I had nothing else to say.
But I think, look, Annabelle was like a child Ford model. It's perfect for ice dance. Okay, we're pushing them all the way. They're going to Worlds. Okay.
And did we pretend Nikita wasn't here for a particular reason, or they just didn't
Excuse me. Both of the ice dance teams are at that magic doctor in Germany that uses Octavagan, okay. Which is controversial, and whatever else he uses that they don't publish about why Usain Bolt goes there. Where all like the special athletes go, which is.
When it's time for a checkup.
When it's time for a checkup, that you know.
Yeah.
No one in Russia, you know, Russians love to tell you that, like, we're afraid of you and, you know, all of this stuff. But then when it comes to medical doctors, that's the one thing they're like,
only the one in Germany.
You cannot get a good doctor in Russia. We are going to Germany. Yes.
Okay.
You do you. All right.
Yeah. I hope it works.
Listen, can he fix my sprain? Because, like, I'll go tomorrow. No judgment.
How is that doing, by the way?
You know, it's getting better. Paula Abdul and I use the same arthritis cream. The one that
basically twins.
And then I also went to get more trexavazine. I had to go to Fairlawn, New Jersey to the Russian pharmacy because they don't sell it in CVS. I don't know why.
Yeah, funny enough, they don't have a Galena's Choice aisle.
Really need one. Okay.
Okay.
She's doing very well, by the way.
I knew she would be. Okay.
She called me this morning. Somehow she told me that, so Galina and Tamara Moskvina were at the 92 Olympics, and the Soviet coaches all shared a house, she was saying. But Natalia Dubova got there like an hour before anyone else. Dubova took a bedroom for herself, and then she gave her husband a bedroom so that the other coaches didn't have one. And I don't know if that's because Tarasova was her competition. Like, maybe, you don't know, all these queens in a house.
So like what, you're telling me Tarasova's sleeping on the couch?
No. Galina and Moskvina shared a twin bed cot in like a storage room for 2 weeks in Albertville. And they would like be cuddling on this thing and like turning in unison so that it wouldn't flip over. Just the visual reminds me of like Estelle Getty and Bea Arthur, like cuddling.
Yes, yes, with singers left and right. Yeah, I'm gonna need a Dramamine. Yeah, okay.
Dear God, okay.
You
know. Definitely. So, anyway.
yeah, you're really taking in that visual.
She said some stuff about the ladies where I'm like, we might get into a Doug Haugh situation that people may
let that go. Leave it at that. Let you draw your own conclusions as to what was said. Yeah. Just gonna drink that water.
Okay. You know, maybe we'll discuss it on See You Live. Okay, anyway.
Yeah, there you go, Patreon.
Patreon.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, she had real precise numbers for people. I mean, direct.
Yeah.
They can look at someone and know how many centimeters tall they are and then how many kilograms, you know.
That's experience, yeah.
My professional opinion. Don't listen, but it's just my professional opinion.
Yeah. Which happens to be a unique profession. Yeah. I'm just gonna leave it. I'm not gonna touch it.
So did you notice the coaches in the ladies' free was the freaking best?
And what we love about this footage is that they constantly have coaching cameras up.
The Marie
at
France
every
cam.
Point. Yeah.
They saw the Marie France cam and knew this is the next front.
And they keep checking. They keep checking on the monitor for when they're in it. And they're in it, and then they would show multiple coaching teams at the same time for certain things. Like, it was very interesting.
To watch Eteri as the girl skated.
Same shenanigans.
No. But I have to say, Eteri won this round, okay? Last week.
But not by a huge margin, not by like some like.
Here, this week, I think she won by a decent margin.
Okay.
Last week, I think it was more even. You know, who cares, right? Juniors.
Yeah. And she would go home feeling better had Shcherbakova landed the quad locks in the free.
Who, I just think she was laughing her ass off this week. I mean, I have to say, she got in Plyshenko's head. He looked so nervous at those
points. Well, I didn't know if this was like him trying to show that he takes it seriously.
This is words from Galina. This is words from Galina.
Okay.
David, let me tell you. Skater, coach. Two different professions. As skater, he may be champion Olympijski. As coach, he is zero. Okay, I mean,
but in that kind of experience also, like that kind, those kinds of nerves, how to handle all that, you know what I mean? Like there's an art form to it, I would think.
I mean, he's completely out of his depth. And like catching up at like, you know, it's like throwing a rookie in and just
right
with some piranhas, right? Like it's just...
Yeah, and you know, I make up in my head how all of this goes, which is not how it goes. I picture him like calling Misha being like, what the hell do I do when they blah, 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 blah. But I don't know how much interaction there is between the two of them.
I imagine his wife needs to be at the boards. Why isn't she? She could do it.
She would fake it. But it's interesting, I also
think that she could like mentally prepare you for war. Jonathan, she took on the mafia and won. She stole a baby from a hospital. You don't think that she could mentally prepare you for competition?
Just someone to skate, yeah.
A legend, okay?
Okay.
Show her some respect, okay?
Oh my gosh. Okay, well, do you want to get into Plyshenko's Angels? I need to talk
yes,
this out.
But I just wanted to have a moment. We just needed to take each coach in, okay?
Yeah, yeah.
So he seems very nervous.
Okay.
Have you noticed that Hot Sergei has been dressing better? Did you notice that he really...
In fact, in the Dave Lee special with the black turtleneck at all, yeah.
Yes, and when I go to like a, you know, a dinner, when we put the jacket over it, I was like, Serioja, I was like, you are just looking like, you know.
He did. And Elenik with that gorgeous hair.
Oh, when she is willing Trusova through the program and like slamming the boards.
Well, we're gonna get into it when we talk about
she is channeling Tatiana Tarasova, she is channeling Morozov. Yeah. Oh my god, is she like, and this Dmitry Mikhailov, who's like the other coach who's working with Trusova, but all right, let's talk about it. So Trusova.
Okay.
Angel number okay. one. Okay.
What program?
Short program, yes. What I don't
and as Roth will say, And he's totally right. We're all looking for this dramatic change that even under the most ideal of circumstances has not had time to truly happen yet. So we don't really know how this is gonna go yet, right?
And Galina wanted us to know, of course these girls are growing. They are not, div, what is that word? You know, parents, normal, person, sick person, not grow, short, like 90 centimeters for life. What is word for this? These girls, they are not, they're growing. So she wants us to know they're not midgets.
Oh my God, no, they're not little people, Dave. We're very PC on this game, Watson, yes. Oh my gosh. Well,
so yeah, and I told her, I said, Muscovina would be perfect for the quads. She's like, oh yes.
You know. Yeah, exactly. She would have done a throw quad lots. Come on. And she wouldn't put her hand over, she put her leg over.
Listen, Muscovina was the people's champion in Russia. Don't you forget it.
Just saying, yeah.
All right.
So here's what I'm gonna say when the short started, knowing that I was like, we're all gonna be looking for a change, we're all gonna be commenting on it. What am I gonna see it? Dave, I thought I saw it. I'm not saying that this is an artist. I'm not saying that this is a skater, but I see someone who I think is taking that kind of improvement seriously, and I see her inching towards it. I see her trying to hold positions longer. I see her trying to be more with the music. And what I particularly liked about Ilyinik, yes, it might have been a bit of showboating, but this kind of like beating of the music in those moments, but that's part of it. Like, it's forcing Trusova to hear the beat and like be in her body with the music. Like, I don't know. I kind of appreciated the step forward there.
I do think though that we have to avoid being Peggy Fleming with the Russian propaganda of the improvement, which is their favorite game to raise the scores.
Okay. But now at least she's probably more on the road to justify the scores she's already been receiving. Like,
there's,
I see
Eteri scores that she's been getting, and there's what she actually deserved. Okay.
Exactly.
It was so bad before.
Yes.
At like 6, 5, 7, 5 level.
For me, unwatchable at times.
She's trying.
Yeah.
So yes, there is a remarkable improvement percentage-wise.
Right.
It is not yet at an acceptable level, but it was so bad before that it's at least...
But I see that by the Olympics, maybe she could be much more towards an acceptable level.
The thing that gets me with her, and we saw her, she wore athletic garb, in the...
Just blasted Adidas all over the place.
Whatever, you got it flaunted, okay? Giannis, that corn, honey. But anyway, the body is so athletic and ripped, right? Like, my God, like Megan Duhamel, gymnast, like, you know, right?
Shredded, yeah.
But because she has been so trained to jump with her arms, when she does the Lutz with the Rapan arms, she doesn't actually get any lift because she's not been trained to jump with her legs. And it was so low on the ice. And you're like,
yes.
If you're not seeing it through Eteri goggles and knowing that Eteri's having, if you're not like, because these girls are starting over after Corona in a sense, right? Like they've grown, they're rebuilding, they look really rough, right? Like they look struggle bus, right? Without knowing, okay, Eteri's girls are going to go 1, 2, 3, and not having that in your mind, like we were so conditioned to last year that, like Rika, when she was wearing the ugly, like grandma drapes, like,
fighting for fourth. Right? Yeah.
When you start to see it with new eyes and not expect and not knowing where they're going to be, I was like, I don't know what kind of GOE you can give that. I don't know if that's special. This doesn't look special to me. That doesn't look special. Overall, I did think that her run of the edge looked better.
It did. And they gave her less clutter, which allowed her to attempt to, she didn't quite get in fully extended positions, but she was at least able to hold some out longer than she's ever been able to before.
And in the Romeo and Juliet, you actually saw that there was some intentional choreography that she did at one point with like her arms and like a lunge position.
But I appreciate that beginning. I do.
A lot of work to do. Like,
Like,
but I think that I trust it's being done, especially with Ilinic there, and just to see her like getting her to focus in on the beat of the music. Again, that's why I was like, I think she's actually in good hands. I think if it can be done, they're going to try to do it with her.
Look, if nothing else, Alena is there for the glamour, for the drama of the kiss and cry. I mean, does she own a fur coat? Because she needs one, all right? Oh my goodness. I love it. Okay. Unbelievable.
Ilya, she's gonna need those quads though, actually, if she's gonna do it. I mean,
well, that's, and in the free, we really saw that there's a struggle there. She was closer in the warm-up, but in competition, you can tell that she has grown and is getting them back. And I don't think we're gonna be seeing 5 quads from her this season. Right. That's not happening.
But we might be seeing better but less, because I think it's interesting, especially with that Eteri way, the amount of repetitions Roth was always saying, like, how many times has someone done this jump the exact same way, and now you're going to try to change it, especially there where it seems like repetition was key to their being so consistent.
Yeah. The thing is, though, it does remind me, I have this fear, and comparing it to gymnastics, I know people that don't follow gymnastics get annoyed, but Christy Phillips, when she went through puberty and Bella had sabotaged her and all this drama happened in 87 because he was trying to get himself to be the head of the national team coach, she wound up switching gyms. And she went to a gym that let her not work as hard as they were forced to work at Caroli's. Her body fell apart like that. I mean, and she even tried to move back and like couldn't get it together just in time to do it. Right? Like it was just missed time by a couple of weeks. I worry for Kostornaia going. She is at this critical, critical moment. She has grown. She is an adult.
She struggles with injuries.
She's going to keep struggling. And it's like a race against, I do not believe that we will ever see her land that quad salchow. So
no.
We
need the triple axel back.
She's not yet in condition. She's had numerous injuries. You could tell, is the off ice where it needs to be? I'm not sure in terms of the strength. She's slower. And I also feel, I know that she's a very opinionated girl and that's come across in her articles when she wants something. And now that she has these titles, she feels like her opinion matters, and it does, but then the opinion of experts also needs it. This Billie Eilish BS, okay.
It's so bad.
It doesn't elevate her skating at
all. No, it fights all of her qualities.
And without her beautiful skating, or a triple axel that's consistent, or even a triple lutz, triple toe that's consistent, it was a mess. It was just this teenager. She just looked, it makes her so ordinary compared to the other girls. She was so exquisite because of the way that they masked and they did. And you have to give some credit to Eteri there. And that's where you need Plushenko and Ilinic to really kind of.
And even they, in my opinion, were barely letting her do it. And I don't know, maybe that's Danny G driving the music choice. Maybe it's Kostornaia herself. I think of her every time I look at my own coasters.
Shaylin Bourne is going to be the one to give her like a sophisticated program, or is Shaylin going to give her like the more edgy program like the free skate last year? Like, you know, we see, you know,
Shaylin did that short?
No, she's doing the free, and that's why
I was going to say, the short was such a miss to me. The music was wrong, the style was wrong, and again, she couldn't showcase anything.
To me, it just was such a miss. I know that if she withdrew, the scandal would have been up the wazoo, right? So she really had to show up here. And there was really no way she was going to win this coming here, or
but her whole shift to them seems so haphazard and last minute and kind of chaotic and unorganized to me.
She's dramatic, that's why we like her.
But the Trusova thing seemed well thought out, like they have a plan for her, they seemed very invested in her, they were at the boards with her, like engaged in a totally different way than it seemed like they were called at the last minute to put Kostornaia on the ice or something. Like, it just didn't seem as
organized. She's not ready. at all. But we could see last year she also had injuries. She was not ready until maybe 2 months from now. So I'm not shocked. And I know that they're saying that they have to compete at the Russian Cups, but we'll see. Look, they are also saying that she wasn't going to be allowed to compete this year until she, look, there's a lot of politics to be played. We have to see, she's still one of their crown jewels who
they don't
have other, as we could see, they have no one else ready to go this season.
Right.
We do not see 20 girls deep who are ready to perform at a high level this season. So, I mean, we even were faking it with that Valieva was a senior, even though she's a junior. So when you take that out, they don't have like this like stable of, you know, girls. I mean, are you gonna send Medvedeva to the world championships? Like, are you kidding me? So.
Well, that was a tough watch this time for me.
So interesting. And this, this gets more in the video. She wanted to host that Ice Age event with Zagitova. She was offered, she accepted, and Eteri said no and put a stop to it. And this has such, and remember, she skated all during quarantine because she was in Japan.
Well, that's what I was thinking. Now, I would try to like give her some more slack if I hadn't known that she didn't really have the disruption that others had. And honestly, some of the tough skating elements remind me of like when we would see Carolina like struggle at first to like kind of come back in a season because she's in her late 20s or something to remember that Medvedeva is only 20.
Yo, when Ted said that.
I know. I was like, she seems like she's struggling as if she was much older than that.
But Ted liked her abs better. He said so many like inappropriate. He commented on all of their bodies. He commented when he said that Misha knows high art. There were some
And he, I think, is his phrase no joke or something? He says something over and over.
He also told us that he's done it all in skating. He's been a coach. He's been this. Now he's a commentator. He's a special man. Jenny says that it sounds like he's in an abusive relationship with Russell Channel One, where like they hit him and then he has to compliment them every commercial break. Like,
amazing. It's true. I was surprised, like, especially because as we watch, we get that disclaimer that says this is sponsored in part or wholly by the government. And then him to just be sort of
I believe it on pretty Jenny's good. Direct quote. I don't know if she won't care. She's funny. She said that Ted would vote for Trump and let Russia cheat for the election and then thank them. She said that that's who Ted is.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
I mean, I have to say, I don't know if his involvement has helped make this so easy to watch. This was easier to watch than almost any other event.
The other bonus event, the other smartest political move that Eteri has ever done that made me laugh so hard, picking the Eric Radford music for the Valieva program, knowing that Eric, it works on the ISU, even though it's in a low position. Look, stroking that ego.
Yeah.
You know, people like Eric, and you know.
Well, and it's actually a very Eteri Danny G kind of sound. That
oh yes,
sort of
it
music.
Is.
Yeah.
And we're always saying they need more. We need more composers. So now we have Eric Radford, and you know what? I thought it worked for an Eteri program as well as any other piece of music. I mean, you're going to hate it, but I thought, you know what?
No, but it fits in that style that they do. Yeah.
It's in that style. I'm like, I thought it worked. Get your coin, Eric. Okay. I'm like, you can write the Eteri soundtracks, each of the girls. Okay.
What did you think of Valieva here?
Eric, this is what I think. Eric, I am live. Get them to have a music imprint. Then what you do, write your own piece of music for each Eteri girl. All those tweenage fans will buy that stuff on iTunes.
Take commissions, yeah.
Get it, okay, get it, all right.
I was intrigued to see how I thought Valieva really sort of matched up to Shcherbakova in particular.
Oh yeah, I think her bolero is a real work of art.
But she-
And even Ed said that she was lacking transitions.
Well, my gosh, at the beginning of the program, it was so peculiar, especially when that music is so iconic and so clear how to interpret. For you to not be doing anything was pretty obvious.
Look, impressive thing is that she missed the first, she's tall as hell. I mean, she's tall.
And kind of evoking some Zagitova aesthetic in sort of the packaging a little bit, I felt. She's very beautiful.
Look, she missed that first quad. Ow. Came back.
That one was wonky. That would be enough to like totally disorient you, I would have thought.
Came back, nailed the second one.
In combo with the double toe.
When you look at these girls, knowing that the Eteri technique is failing like clockwork, look at how hard it looks for Trusova and Shcherbakova, even when they land stuff, how much more effort it takes compared to last year. Kostornaia didn't even do a free. Valieva is tall. Daria's not really a great competitor. Maya Kromich, not a star. Who's Russia going to send to the Olympics as their slam dunks? I mean, this is like not...
We need to get our red-haired girl going.
Yeah, I mean... Let's get in the game. I mean, it opens the door, right?
Did Valieva represent herself in a way that now makes her on the world team of three?
Well, she's too young, so.
Oh, she is still.
She's still, yeah.
Okay.
It's just to prepare her and to mentally and to prepare the audience of thinking her in that way, if they are in that way. So they're playing some games, okay. And I think she's where she was last year. I think she's still in that. Look, she's ahead of Kostornaia right now. So
yeah.
But we'll see. Right, yeah. Like, will happen. She's getting taller by the day. You know, like so.
But the second quad toe was pretty lovely.
Yeah. The program wasn't anything.
No, I actually found the short program more effective than the Bolero was just nothingness and arbitrary and just really fell short. And then you think like, do you think you're creating a masterpiece? Or
you can go back to the Picasso program for the Olympics and just focus on it, because this is, find some choreographer in Russia, anyone.
Right. Maybe that will at least give you the right music. Mm.
Well, there is no more creative show in the world than Cirque du Soleil.
Oh my gosh, when he said that, I was like, what is this real life? What is happening here? And it was such a hodgepodge of like, and then like this from Saltimbanco, this from that one. And you know, she like quasi tried to do the moves, but not enough. And then when she bombed the, this is
and she practiced her spins ever. And this is what I really get.
The cartwheel and the gloves. Like
there was a lot of showmanship going on here. We have Brian Orser over FaceTime, as if he can see a frickin' thing. You know that his computer is next so that he can watch it on the monitor, what's happening. Like, right. He see when she's...
And he can FaceTime her afterwards. Like, what is this immediate?
That's to show that she's working with a gold medal winning coach. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
It is about his stature. Okay.
Yeah.
But you think you're in the rink with Buyanova. She's also coached an Olympic champion. You're working with Tarasova. But I have a question here with Tarasova.
Did you see Tarasova's face after the short?
We have to get into it. So Galina, Div, this program, Medvedeva, Masquerade, what? This must be choreographed American, Canadian person. This is not a professional person. Masquerade, what?
Who did it?
In Russia, let me tell you, a girl wears long skirt, and you know, the beat is Rastavatri, Rastavatri, Rastavatri.
Yes! Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Yeah.
And so what she was saying is that the pose, how Medvedeva, how she likes to end, like on her knees and like this, like that's complete antithetical of a waltz. Like a girl that's that glamorous would never do a pose. Like that. So what the hell are you doing?
Yeah, it's of the wrong era of music.
But I think that that's Medvedeva's own look. This is a girl who was chosen and raised by Eteri because she's a headstrong fighter. And it works for you until it works against you. And now we're at the point where she seems delusional, right? Like where people are like, you need to quit. And we see because there's no other outlet for skating but to make be competitive.
Even when she tries to take it, aka hosting Ice Age,
you see it like she needs to be in some like Marie France production, because this is, she still can skate and perform, and I think she still has passion.
Yet she still has something to give, but it's not in under-rotated sow-cow combos, for your sure, you know.
It was a loop toe, right? But it was not...
Oh, sorry.
She did the sow-cow toe, probably under the free... but yes, it was, I mean, it was just mistakes that were just mind-numbing. And
yeah, missing axle entrances, doubling the flip, falling on the cartwheel, some odd...
No, that got really messy. Because again, this is a girl who has been... And I know that she has injuries. And of course, every Russian girl had... Almost all of them had planned excuses. Except for the Eteri girls. Did you notice that Kostornaia had all of that drama? We knew it was coming in. To Demisheva...
Something she just stayed quiet this time, kind of.
She looked like roadkill in that documentary. She's better here. But it, does she have a back injury? Like, she just is not moving, like...
Yeah. Well,
right? She looked worrying in that documentary. She really looked much better here, I have to say. The other one, we find out that Sofia Samadurova had a fever. Did not do the free. She also looked like hell in the shirt, right? You know, like, they each have, like, a built-in excuse.
Well, Sophia, she's just always marveled.
Evgenia, they told her not to jump, but she did jump. But, like, this whole, please, like, you're going to go to the test gates and not do any jumps when you're Medvedeva and they already shit on you constantly.
Right.
That drama. Right. How's that going to go over? Of course, she do something.
Right.
So I didn't really believe that. That seemed like a planned PR move to me. Whatever, they're all playing, it's strategy. It's like Big Brother, they're all playing something, okay? But okay. I don't really like, and you know what, she showed here, she had to show up here, she did. But the spins look like she has not practiced them since she left Eteri. Then she was saying something that like, oh, I didn't go for the donut spin. She was saying, it just looked like a lot of theatrics when she was talking to him on FaceTime. It was very performative. It was like her whole speech in the exhibition when her boot broke at the Nationals. Like, it just felt like a lot of
extra,
which we love, but it's getting tiring.
Yeah.
Right? Like, it feels like she's Oksana Bayul swinging the phone around. And we're like, all right, now we actually want you to do a triple X. Like,
exactly.
like we liked you with the lamp, but this is too far. Okay.
Yeah. The line is actually where you've just moved it. Yeah.
She had some cool things in the Allegria thing. Like when she did that thing with her arms and she was like doing, like she was-
No, see, that's the part I hated the most.
I appreciate that there was an effort to do something. Okay.
Yeah. Because but it was so specific and niche, that kind of movement, that you're like, it was even more apparent now that that was the only time we saw that.
Now, apparently, there were all these reports and articles about, like, who drove who home from the, I don't understand, but, like, Tarasova drove her home, but do you notice that Tarasova wasn't there today? I did not see her.
Because they were showing her a lot, and she was not pleased after Evgenia's short.
How would you, her expression, like, what would, like...
With that dark purple lip, and she just was, like, pressed,
Why didn't Tarasova fix the kneeling thing at the end of the masquerade wall? She would know, and she was helping her. I was confused.
I didn't see necessarily, I would say,
you can't ask really questions really on the phone. She just goes into monologues. So there's no way.
Got it. You're just taking what you can get. Yeah.
Okay.
What about Shcherbakova?
We're not done with this thing. Jonathan. She was like, and she knows the camera is on her. She's telling you what we, and I had the same reaction.
She looked right at it. Everyone's clapping and she was choosing not to, and then made that exasperated sigh. Yeah. In case you missed it.
And, I mean, her expression said everything about Evgenia's future. And she knew it, we knew it as viewers. You could say, oh, she just needs, you could do the Ted angle all you want, but it was like.
Well, Ted's angle was particularly odd because he was basically trying to tell us if we didn't get it, it's because we weren't smart enough. And I was like, oh no, we're plenty smart.
Look, Ted is enjoying his position and he's going to keep it, Jonathan, okay?
Because he's doing the things he needs to do in order to do so.
He doesn't care if we like it. Look, he's making a point.
Channel One does.
He feels a part of the leading edge of skating and all right.
There you go.
I thought
I switched over to the Russian commentary, by the way, for the short program.
Oh my God, was it much better?
Well, why, I don't have.
Why didn't Rob commentate? I mean,
come on.
I want to feel her power when she's watching.
Yeah, I want to hear that sigh happen during the skating.
Bravo. Oh, I don't know.
And Evgenia also, like, everyone was in sort of like practice gear to certain points, but she was full blown in like a sports bra. And it just seemed like out of place. It seemed too informal. Like there did seem to be a bit of decorum even in people's practice outfits.
Did you notice when the Kardashians grew that the longer they were on reality TV, the more their behavior seems strange to the public? I think it's the same thing when you have these child stars. Like 1 year.
They become caricatures, yeah.
So now you know Evgenia is gonna give you some over the top drama and there's gonna
be.
And if Brian Orser is coaching her on FaceTime and he's not coaching Hanyu and Jason is really Tracy and Karen's baby, who is he working with? Like the Polish girl with the under rotations? Like what is he doing? Okay, he couldn't fake it in the free. I mean, okay, when she skated through the axle, when she missed the cartwheel.
And then laughed, you know, like we're all just having fun.
Laughing at her own bad performance. That gets to be insulting as a viewer. I would be angry as a coach at that point.
Yeah.
Because she's a very experienced skater. Obviously, she's going to feel some insecurities going up against these girls who are more advanced technically than she is at this point. But she is such a veteran that she should at least be working as hard to put through. And there's an interview with Kostornaia that I'm going to read later when I did the video where she was talking about how if she doesn't want to do the program in the morning with jumps, Plushenko doesn't make her. And I was just getting that vibe where, are you slacking off a bit? Because like this is...
And is Plushenko letting you because maybe he's not as invested? It seems like the focus came with Trusova and Kostornaia was like an afterthought tack on to that.
That he's not as invested? Or is it that he's not in a place where he has the gravitas? He needs you more than you need him right now.
Yeah.
Because he hasn't done anything as a coach. And until he does, she can walk over you, right?
Right.
She has the power and like we're all, but now he has more of the power because she embarrassed herself here. So like that's how this kind of evens out and she needs to get in gear. It was rough. But Medvedeva, I wouldn't pay to send her to a Grand Prix. I know that the ISU pays for that, but if Russia had to pay for her to go to an event, like I would not bankroll. To not do spins, to skate through an axle, to miss your cartwheel and laugh, I don't know. It was just a weird demeanor and there's been a lot of things. Like, it reminds me of when Johnny Weir skated into the boards at Nationals that 1 year and then had to rebuild and go to like the sectionals and he had to go to the Mid-Atlantics to curry favor with judges for Skating Club in New York and things like that. Like she's at that point for me. Shcherbakova, what do you think?
I thought she was the star of the event.
Yes.
I thought that her packaging was outrageously classy. I thought...
Especially the free.
Yes. Gorgeous, simple, elegant. I find that she has always been musical, but this, now they're giving her better music in general. Mm-hmm. I mean, obviously like Stravinsky is amazing and all that sort of stuff, but like they're continuing to kind of get her. I find the treatment of her and her program is the finest maybe that camp has delivered in a while. Not that I still think she's not more deserving of a better program, but like it was elegant. I don't know. I really enjoyed watching it. I don't know about the jumps.
The jumps are a struggle. And you can see it the most on her triple flip.
Yeah. And
remember last year she was trying a quad flip. I mean, those days are gone. But you do see when she does the triple flip, it is the most effort and slamming that toe in. And I mean, that rough technique, but she's a determined girl. She is, she moves beautifully when she wants to, and it's not sickling her foot, which they need to work on. But overall, she looks very elegant.
She took more time. They allowed in the program for her to take more time. And I found that, I think these could really grow to be lovely programs for her.
The mesh sleeves are stunning on her. The look.
So classy, so classy.
So much, each time a girl left, they put more effort in that free program.
It's 100%, it's 100% true. I saw them pull out all the stops that they knew how in order to class her up.
Eteri had her cross on like a good Christian girl. She was.
Yeah, I noticed that, yeah. She,
clapping for Medvedeva here. I mean, Eteri's performance was top notch this weekend.
Well, unfortunately, the same could not be said for Elisabetta Tutimishina.
so much gold in the short.
You came up with that term, like the Halloween costume choreography, and she legit wore the Halloween costume with the gold thing over the boot. It was very. Now, someone on Twitter was mentioning Spartacus with the seagulls. That's real. That's actually in the soundtrack.
Okay.
I know, it's too bad.
That was because the expensive thing about her skating here. So.
Exactly. There are ways, like I think we've heard people take it out, but if you listen closely, a lot of the famous Spartacus programs have those sounds. Listen, I like the music for skating. I think like, well, she's not gonna skate to the music regardless, so. I wasn't quite sure how to take
it. I think we need an Ice Wars with Medvedeva and Tutimishina against
Sotnikova.
Against Ashley Wagner and Gracie Gold with like commentary by Tracy Wilson and Alina Zagitova. Like, I just. Let's be real here. I mean, could she get the triple axel and make a push for this year?
Well, it's like you're saying, she seemed to have actually started at a major deficit. Like, she does seem like she took that actual time off and is now scrambling to come back quickly. Like you said, like the difference between the footage of her in that documentary to now was immense. I wonder if she's just behind on her schedule. Because the triple axel was close enough in the free, like that I feel like she's almost there.
People said she was landing it in practice, perhaps, so...
And again, those quads and the Zagreb practices had me so excited last year. I don't know if that's her goal to try that again, because of course when she does them, like when Rika does them, they just look a little bit different than everybody else's. But Elisabeth is in particular.
Her back. That's what I want to know. It just, the way she's moving looks like she's like...
Very labored. And I didn't know if that was injury or if it was just fine.
You know, like she doesn't look as agile. I mean, the free, she's up to her. Just put the muumuu on Tutimishina, get the old music out. And
it's
like,
all variations on a theme, isn't it? Yeah, these outfits now.
Just come on. Just get it out. Let's get
Again.
It. Again. It was your best year. It's what the public wants. Where's Elena Rodionova? Okay, like Rodionova. Like, where is she? Okay, put on the J-Lo and let's-
Pogorilaya, bring back Anna. Yeah.
Ba, 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 da, ba. Come on. I mean, where was she? Okay. I know. It was.
Just to be coaching it.
Fun to see these girls, man. Oh my.
It felt good to just be like watching in real time and watching, you know.
Mishin's face when Tutimishina did that single axel or didn't do a combination.
Well, it was his female cohort that was giving us all the facial antics this time, especially about Elisabetta. And Sofia Samadurova.
Is that his wife? I can never tell which. Is that Mishin's wife? Like, who is that woman? Is that?
Oh, see, I assumed you would know. That's why I was referring to her like vaguely.
I don't know.
I think they're married. Are they not?
I mean, what's his biography? You know, we don't have it in.
We've seen the footage of him skating with Masmina, but we need to know the deal on the
maybe Masmina court. Can tell us all of their biography. Maybe she should write it. You know?
Yeah, exactly. That's how long this girl's been sticking around.
So for some reason, Galina seems to think that Tommy Collins' name is Toma Collins. You know, oh, when we are on Toma Collins tour, they would
as if it's one word, yeah.
And apparently Moscovita would be up on the computer all night working. You know, she works.
I believe that.
Yeah. So what's she doing? She needs to write another book. How's she doing? You know, she's...
Yes, yes.
I'm my God. But yeah, I think these are some stars.
What's coming up this week, Dave?
Well, we're going to have some, I'm sure, some fallouts from the Tescade. And I think everyone's going to give their opinion on why Kostornaia looked like that. And I'm sure we'll get everyone in Russia's opinion. We're going to get those videos of the Japanese men. And we're going to...
Which is exciting.
And there's more videos coming out from the US skaters as they're moving towards these events. We're moving towards the Russian Cup. So there's a lot of stuff coming out here.
And some Patreon excitement.
Yes, we are going to be
throwing it back.
We're going to be judging the 2000 World Figure Skating Championships with some of our favorite girls, okay?
The old favorites.
Yes, when a Russian girl looked like she was 27, smoked a cigarette, put on her makeup, and went out there with a pissed off attitude. I mean, those were the days, my friend, okay?
And you know what? They would have landed their cartwheel.
They would have landed their cartwheel. Vanessa Guzmaroli doing the split on the ice to let you fall. Yeah. Come on, okay? Some Robin Wagner action. Yes. Yes.
It was a different time. Yeah.
Oh. And there was a stabbing at the Worlds in Nice. Remember the French team? There were, like, yes.
No, I don't remember that at all.
Yes, there was some drama, and they're like...
Oh, I'm going to have to really go and relive.
Remember, Sally and Peltier were like on a meteoric rise, and they thought that Worlds were going to be their year, and then they bombed, and then there was many tears and the kiss and cry, and Bereshnai and Sikorlitsa, like, they got a last-minute notification that they had an Andrea Radikon situation, so that it was a very dramatic World Championships.
And we'll be there judging it.
We'll be there. I can't wait. Yes.
Exactly.
Yes, I cannot wait. Oh my God. Oh. And the other day, we were just watching First Position, and that little Aaron Bell, the little boy that has like the spinner and the foot.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He got promoted to principal of American Ballet Theater. It feels like...
Oh, exciting.
The sons are growing up and they are just...
Exactly. Getting their just reward. Okay.
I just hope one day he could get like a good tattoo of like Vladimir Putin and self-harm, like Oyunik's fiance, Sergei Balunin.
It's one way to get a documentary.
One way. Okay. Apparently there's another documentary about him. I'm such a fan. Okay.
All the choices. Okay.
You know.
A prolific output, yeah.
Problematic tweets. He's perfect for skating. Okay.
Okay.
Remember, Nikolai Morozov, only person wearing a mask in this whole event. Right. There was a very cute man that was helping Annabelle, like...
The blonde?
What's his backstory? I don't remember him, but...
Yeah.
He looks like one to know. I don't know.
We'll investigate. We do enjoy these investigative kiss and cry.
He could one day work as like an angel of Plushenko. Like, we don't know.
Could be tomorrow.
Do you think Ilinik is like above taking a photo like with like the guns? Like it's 2001 and she'll be like this. And then like Kostornaia will be like this. And like Trusova.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. They'd all have to be there at the same time. That's the thing.
I'm seeing the possibilities.
Okay.
She comment on Instagram. She's like, you know, people think that she and Sergei look very attractive together at the boards. I'm like, I'm into this, okay?
Yeah, bring it, bring it.
Theater. Hold an edge and look sexy, everyone.